went on a date recently. I made a real effort in my 30s, I'm 31, made a real effort to try to date normal guys. Because when you're in your 20s, you can date whoever you want because you'll live forever and you're hot and you're in your 20s, right? You're like, what, you wanna go out? We're both carbon-based, let's do it. And it's like, fine. Try to make some responsible choices in my 30s. Recently, I went out with someone based solely on the way he was dressed. He was an accountant, but okay. Okay, I'll carry the conversation, that's fine. He had a plaid shirt tucked into khakis, okay, all right. Little nerdling, that's okay. Cell phone and a holster on his hip. Dad style. To the dads in the audience and subsequently watching this, what text is coming in so fast you have to have your hand ready, okay, Corral style? And then what are you sending out so fast that it's rendering your cellular device smoking and you've got to holster it? But the point is, he was dressed responsibly. He was dressed non-threatening, dressed nice, like an adult. And I knew I had to respond in kind. I couldn't dress like a 19-year-old lesbian Hot Topic manager. I get it. Made a real effort, folks. I'm gonna tell you right now, I made a real effort. I asked my girlfriends that are like in their mid-30s, they've been dating a while, they're very mature, right? What should I wear? You need to get like a silk blouse. So just wear it and then just cover that shit up and just like tuck it in, blouse it out, silk blouse. I'm here to say right now, I reject a silk blouse. Fuck a silk blouse, okay? Yes. Just because you're not 20 doesn't mean you have to be ashamed of your body. I don't need to wear a tent over it, okay? They're burkas for American women. I said it and I meant it. All right? They're oppressive, they're ugly, they're hot, they're shapeless, and if you wear an underwire bra under your silk blouse and you sweat through it, it's gonna look like a face with its eyes closed. Fuck a silk blouse. But I bought one anyway, like whatever. Went to a nice store, made a real effort. I went to a Nordstrom's. I asked the sales girl, she was like 19 and just like hot. And I was like, I need a silk blouse. She was like, what about this one? It was white, it had black splotches all over it. And she was like, it's abstract. I was like, yeah, like a Rorschach test, but less interesting. She's like, I don't get it. I'm like, that's because you work here. Okay. No, it's like a fun pattern. I'm like, that's a cow print, like 100%. It's black splotches. I'm gonna look like a model for Gateway printers. I'm not wearing that. Because here's the fact, with prints like that, it's a cow print. You can't wear it if you're a normal girl. If you're a model, you can wear something stupid and look hot. If you're a model, you can wear a blousy cow print and be like, fuck yeah, moo, motherfuckers. Moo, yeah, right? Not dicks, udders. Normal girl wearing a cow pattern, if you tuck in a blousy cow, you're just gonna look like a cow that had gastric bypass surgery. Just like blousy. Tucked in blousy cow, so I got it. Tucked in blousy cow, blouse it out. And then I bought pants that were very tight. You're going on a date, you wanna wear tight pants. The tighter the pant, the more effort it shows you've put into it, okay? Not unlike Chinese foot binding. You want your pants so tight that they form your muscles and bones into this kind of like palsy effect, okay? And you wanna have shoes that are so high, the heel is so high that you are literally cantilevered off the edge and it forms a dainty hump in the back. Men like this, trust me, men love a good hump, okay? Like this. So you're ready, so you've got blousy cow palsy pants and you want your shoes to be so high that you can't run from your rapist if you want, so super high. Blousy cow, palsy pants, and I was ready for the date. And we went on our date.